What an incredible game.
It's awesome, baby. What a game.
Is he the next big thing? Is
he? He shoots at the horn.
He's good.
Bradley wins 63-62.
30 feet away. Jumper in the air. He's got it.
To the dance.
Let the celebration begin.
Hits the shot and Villanova pulls off the upset.
And Lehigh hopes that history repeats itself. They have not been to the NCAA tournament since 1988, hoping to win the Patriot League for the first time as they take on American. These are the top two seeds in the Patriot League. American has never gone to the NCAA tournament, and these two teams about to face each other on Lehigh's home court in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. It is Selection Sunday. Pam Ward joined by Steve Labin. Five more automatic bids will be handed out today, starting with the Patriot League. And, Steve, this is not one of your bigger conferences, obviously, so this is sort of the ultimate. You win this tournament and you go to the big one.
Yeah, well, 2 hours from now, you're going to have one group of kids. Obviously, they're going to be devastated because they're so close to crossing that finish line and living the dream, being one of the 65 teams in the field of 65. And then, on the other hand, you're going to have a team that's not going to be part of it. So this is what it's all about. One team wants to get there, one team doesn't.
And one team will be devastated, the other will be thrilled to pieces to go to the NCAA tournament. Coming up, we have more basketball. The ACC Championship at 1 Eastern time, followed by Texas and Oklahoma State. They play for the Big 12. Championship week presented by 7-Up. And right now, Patriot League basketball, Doug Gottlieb and Dave Repson.
Okay, Pam, they're charged up in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, and with good reason. Lehigh, one of the best turnaround stories of the last 2 years in college hoops. Today, they try to take the ultimate step by getting into the NCAA tourney, facing an American team that has come up one game short of the dance each of the last two seasons. Championship week presented by 7-Up, the Patriot League Championship. These are the top two seeds, both 10-4 in the league. Lehigh has the home court by virtue of two regular season wins over the Eagles. You see how they advance to this final game. Dave Repson, Doug Gottlieb with you in our Star Watch, Doug, focusing on the backcourt.
Yeah, the backcourt filled with a couple of transfers. Andres Rodriguez, the Louisville transfer, can flat out take over a game, whether it's passing or scoring the basketball. And Austin Rowland, the player of the year in this conference. He also likes to dish it out, but as he goes, so goes the Mountain Hawks of Lehigh.
Rodriguez, fourth in the nation in assists, so you want to keep an eye on him. Again, Dave Repson, Doug Gottlieb with the American will be wearing the blue, Lehigh in the white. As Pam told you, Lehigh has not been to the tourney since 1988. American has never been to the NCAA tourney. This is a Lehigh team that was 5-23 2 years ago. Billy Taylor has done a remarkable job with them. American also a great turnaround story, although it's been a little bit longer that Jeff Jones has had it going. Third straight winning season on the heels of 10 straight losing seasons for American. So we are ready to go in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. NCAA tournament bid on the line in the Patriot League. It's American against Lehigh, and American wins. The tip there, and Rodriguez, the guy we highlighted off the top, has it. This is Jason Thomas. Now Andre Ingram. Thomas going to try the three, and he's got it.
Jason Thomas, a 35% three-point shooter, but with any shooter, when he catches the ball in rhythm and no hand in his face, the percentages tend to go up.
Austin Rowland, who Doug talked about a moment ago, handling it there. Now the jumper no good by Jose Olivero. And American comes out of it with Patrick Okpie controlling the rebound. Janaeus Drawn can't get it to go. Battle for the rebound, and Jason Engebroff has it for Lehigh. And it's going to go to the Mountain Hawks. Taking a look at the lineups for Jeff Jones' Eagles. We told you about Rodriguez. Andre Ingram, the other starter to keep an eye on. Patriot League Freshman of the Year, leads them in scoring at nearly 14 points per game.
And Jarnaeus Drawn is a guy who creates mismatches, especially at this level. Undersized, but inside, he is so athletic and so difficult to cover, especially on the offensive and defensive boards.
That is Rowan. He has it partially blocked. Now American running the other way. It's Drawn inside. Can't handle it. And it's going to go to the Mount Hawks. For the Mount Hawks, coached by that man, Billy Taylor, Roland, the big star. Jose Oliveros had an outstanding freshman year, averages about 12 a game, and Taylor absolutely loves his competitiveness.
Yeah, Olivero is a guy, as a true freshman, came in and just lit it up the first quarter of the season. And the middle part of the season kind of had that freshman slump. They thought he was fatigued, and now he's kicked it back in for the end of the year.
Evan Gabroff gets the first two for the Mountain Hawks.
And credit Austin Roland, the ability to see the floor, despite the fact that your player of the year averages 5 assists a game. He always has his head up, always looking for his teammates, despite the double team.
Taking it strong to the hole and missing right there was Jarnaeus Drawn. Now the three on the way from Roland. That's not there. Battle for the rebound. And coming out of there with it is Patrick Oakpot. This is Rodriguez. As you mentioned, a transfer from Louisville, played just 2 games for Louisville. He'd been walk on there. His grandfather actually went to med school there, had a connection with Denny Crum, but he wasn't going to play all lots. Come to America and has made a huge impact for them.
And that's the difference in levels of programs. You come to somewhere that you're going to play, somewhere a fine academic institution, as both of these schools are. And there's nothing like playing when you've been sitting over there for a couple years.
That's Andre Ingram missing. Earl Nurse coming out of there with the rebound.
Collecting dust, as they say.
Olivero through the lane, can't get it to go.
It seems like both teams are playing a little too quick. I mean, obviously, only nationally televised game for either of these teams, but just the drives are shot a little quicker than they normally would. The jump shots are a little stronger than they normally should be, and that's to be expected.
They get it inside to Nurse. Goes up, no call, and then they give the ball to American. Well, Nurse certainly thought he had drawn a foul there on Jarnaeus Drawn.
Well, it looked like he jumped in to try and create contact, and sometimes when you do so, the official says, you know what, let's just play it as even, see if the ball goes in.
So now Rodriguez. Jeff Jones says he's the straw that stirs the drink for them. Nice feed inside, and they get it to go. Patrick Oakpie gets his first two.
But credit Rodriguez, getting in the lane, creating for his teammates, averages 7.3 assists a game, fourth in the country. And he is a guy who does stir the drink by creating with his offense, whether it's penetration, whether it's shooting the basketball, or on the fast break.
M. Gabroff can't get it to go. Rebound, though, kicked out. Jose Olivero. That's not good. And American comes the other way, trying to build on a 5-2 lead. Rodriguez for three. That was something he didn't really have in his game last year. He misses that one. And Austin Rowland brings it the other way. The player of the year in this league. Transfer out of Delaware. Playing just 1 year. Beautiful feed there to M. Gabroff, who gets fouled.
And apparently Rowland's loosened up. Watch the shakes. Ooh, a little crossover. Brings the double team. Not afraid to dish a rocket. You know, Dave, when your best player, when the player of the year in the conference is unselfish, a lot of times the rest of the team becomes unselfish.
Foul goes on Jarnaeus Drawn, number one on him. We'll send M. Gabroff to the line. Came from Kent, Washington, did the freshman, largely unrecruited in high school, because he suffered a couple of stress fractures in his feet during a four-month span. After his junior year, he missed out on some of the prime recruiting period. As Kevin Tempest checks into the game for Lehigh, they've got a real connection to the state of Washington here at Lehigh. As M. Gabroff hits both of them, a lot of that due to Matt Logie, who is the Mountain Hawks all-time leader in three-pointers made. Went to Mercer Island High School.
Great shooter.
There.
Yeah.
So the alma mater of Quinn Snyder.
Yes. Also a great shooter.
Yes. Must be some in the water. Mercer Island. Now Thomas is going to try the three. That's not there. Nurse has the rebound for Lehigh.
And see the difference in Thomas's made three and that three-point shot. That one was rushed. The one he made the first possession of the game. He had his feet set, was up in rhythm. That's why he made it.
There's Rowland through the lane trying to create something. And tracking down the rebound is Nick Monsere. Now rolling down to the corner. He's got it. Working on the blocks. Back out to Rodriguez. Thinks about trying another one. Penetrates instead. And
beautiful feel. He's not a great shooter, but he can still use the ball fake and got rolling off balance. Penetrates to the right, high off the glass. The big guy can't come over and block.
7-7 ball game. The first 5 minutes here from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Nick Monsere throws it away. Some great hustle right there by Jason Thomas. He's going to go to Lehigh when we come back. The two stars stepping up early. Austin Rowland hitting the three. Andres Rodriguez doing his part as well. We got a tight ball game early on here in Pennsylvania. It's 7-7 in the Patriot League Championship.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up and your local 7-Up bottler. Make 7-Up yours.
We are back in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. That's what they're playing for, the Patriot League Championship. We are all tied up 7 apiece between American and Lehigh. Dave Reps and Doug Gottlieb with you. And the thought that Lehigh would be in this game a couple years ago, Doug, would have been flat out laughable. I mean, they were 5-23 the season before Billy Taylor took over. Since then, 35-22 in his two seasons. How's he done it?
Well, he's done it with preparation. Here's a guy who played under John McLeod at Notre Dame. He's actually recruited by our own Digger Phelps, but John McLeod teaches and preaches one thing: preparation. Preparation. Sounds like three things, but it's really, it all grows into one big philosophy. That is, if you are prepared and if you are patient with your team, allow them to grow, you're going to be successful. And the one thing you ask coaches around this league or teams that have competed with Lehigh, they said, they know everything we run.
Austin Rowland missing right there. Now the rebound goes to Jarnaeus Tron, and here comes American. Tron taking himself into the front court, drops it back for Rodriguez. He's going to shoot the three. That's not there, and tipped around. Rowland trying to chase it down. It'll be American basketball.
And going back with Billy Taylor a little bit, the head coach at Lehigh, not only is he prepared, but he also allows his team to have confidence. I mean, they've had players that sit on the bench for the most part of the year and have come in and been major contributors, and that comes from his belief. A guy named Kevin Tempest, who's a sophomore from Mercer Island, another Washington guy, barely played early this season, came in late in the year and scored some big buckets, and it's all because the confidence he instills even in his bench players.
Andre Ingram, Patriot League freshman of the year, who we told you about, drops in the three there to give American the lead. Billy Taylor, just 30 years old. Amazing that he'd be a Division I head coach at that age. Even more amazing when you realize he spent 4 years working for Arthur Anderson. He's a CPA as well. So it's been a quick trip up the coaching ladder for him. Jump shot is missed by Kyle Neptune. Jarnaeus Tron now for American. Nice pass inside to Tron.
And Rodriguez, not a particularly good jump shooter, but allows that jump shot to still be a weapon because he has the consciousness that, look, if I'm confident in taking these shots, players are still going to run out at me defensively. And you look as he sets his feet. He just took this very same shot and missed it the last time down the floor, but sees his teammate inside, and whoop, I'll take a layup.
Explains why the man is fourth in the nation in assists, Andres Rodriguez. Hey, Championship Week presented by 7-Up, continuing with two more games on ESPN today. First and one Eastern, it is Maryland taking on the fourth-ranked Duke Blue Devils. ACC Championship game. It's been a great run for Maryland so far in the tournament. And at 3 Eastern, a big one. Number 11, Texas, meeting number 7, Oklahoma State. The Phillips 66 Big 12 Championship. The Big 12 Championship game also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Championship Week presented by 7-Up on ESPN and ESPN2. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.
I'm sure Duke and Oklahoma State both thinking the same thing. How many times do we have to beat these guys? The third time both these teams meet, and both the favorites have swept the two previous meetings.
Oklahoma State perhaps playing for a number one seed if they were to win that game. Duke, most people feel, safely has a number one seed locked up. Austin Rowland tries to get it inside, and the ball goes off the backboard and out of bounds off the the hands of Dane Mickelson. So it's going to go to American.
A beautiful pass there from Roller. He sees his teammate cutting to the basket. Maybe the bounce pass was a little tough to handle. But still, his ability to see the floor, despite the fact that he's the leading scorer, is something that most coaches would tell you is irreplaceable.
Roland sits down. Ratia comes in. This is a very balanced team. They've been led in scoring by 10 different players this season. Lehigh has led in rebounding by 8 different players. 12 guys have played in at least 19 of their 28 games. All 12 average at least 7 minutes per game. So we'll see a lot of different players for the Mountain Hawks. Tay Kresnik. Now the jumper is good, and that's Andre Ingram hitting again. So 5 points for him. And American out to a 14-7 lead. M. Gabroff. Kyle Neptune. Ratia cuts into the lane, but his pass is stolen away. Here comes Andres Rodriguez, always with the head up. Rodriguez going right to the hole, dishes it off, and we've got a foul inside.
As we take a peek at what American likes to do offensively, watch the pass to the wing. A little UCLA screen, and then setting the man up, coming off of the jump shot. He goes over the top, and Andre Ingram with a clear jump shot, but it's because of the player movement. Using the UCLA screen, all of a sudden the man is at the disadvantage, and then the down screen, and constantly screening and re-screening is why Jeff Jones has been successful as a head coach of Virginia, and now at American U.
That foul was on Dane Mickelson. First on him, first on the team as well. Just 2 fouls total in this game. Rodriguez taken to the lane, and there's foul number 3 as Ratia bumped him.
Well, Jeff Jones has done a marvelous job resurrecting his own program. They only won 7 games his first year at American. We remember him as the longtime head coach at Virginia, a player at Virginia. But that stat's a little bit deceiving, only 50% of the wins, because they only won 7 games in his first season.
That led Virginia to an Elite Eight. Trying to get American into the big dance for the first time ever. Ratia with the steal for Lehigh. This is Kyle Neptune, a very good freshman for Lehigh. Cut off on the baseline. He's going to stay with the Mountain Hawks.
And a difficult portion of the game here for Billy Taylor's Lehigh Mountain Hawks. I'm used to saying engineers. The engineers are so long.
Back.
But you know, you're playing without your best player, who is not only your leading scorer, but also leads you in assists. Now you have to find ways to manufacture points.
And Gabroff hits the pull-up. The freshman has been very impressive so far. 6 points for him.
And he's a guy whose teammates said, you know, quite frankly, early in the year, we feared throwing the ball to him because he might drop it and turn the ball over. But now, as his confidence grows, so does their confidence in throwing in the basketball.
Andres Rodriguez working around the screens from Kresnik there. Serena is in the game as well for American. He wears 23. Rodriguez, great spin, beautiful dish. And that's going to put Raymondis Petrauskas on the line. Jason M. Gabroff gets called for the foul number 1 on him.
Watch as he uses, again, the jump shot as his weapon. They're trying to go under the high screen because he's not a great shooter and he's so little. But by bringing the ball up like you're going to shoot the jump shot, Ratia, all of a sudden he has to close. And Rodriguez again gets into the lane, creates for his teammate.
Petrauskas hits the first one, part of a Lithuanian connection for American. Guy who barely spoke English when he arrived in the U.S. In fact, had just 3 words. Coke, hot dog, and popcorn.
Dave, hot dog is 2 words.
That's an interesting discussion. I think we can really take that up when we come back. Lehigh has won 12 straight at home. And as we take a look at now, actually that score is reversed. It is 16-9 in favor of American. Later today, ESPN, the exclusive unveiling of the 2004 Women's Championship brackets at 5 Eastern. Reese Davis, Nell Fortner, Stacey Dale Schumann breaking down the 2004 NCAA Women's Championship. SportsCenter follows at 6 Eastern. And at 7 Eastern, bracketology in session. Chris Fowler, Nick Vitale, Digger Phelps get reaction from some of the teams involved in this year's tournament. Prepare you to fill out your brackets. Bracketology 101, the NCAA Men's Selection Special, presented by Staples. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.
And, you know, if you're busy, which you should be on Selection Sunday, you should be parked in front of ESPN. It should be. But if you're busy, you're driving around, I'll actually be doing ESPN Radio Selection Show also at 7 o'clock Eastern Time.
You'll be doing that until the cows come home.
Yes, you'll have to be visualizing the brackets, which is much more difficult to do.
M. Gabroff now to Rod Tia. American on a 9-2 run to take this lead, but Tia hits a nice hanger in the lane.
And Tia, tremendously athletic at the defensive end, at the offensive end. When he gets in that lane, the mid-range game, he's incredibly explosive for the Mountain Hawks.
Was a starter for much of the year, but has been willing to defer to Jose Olivero, who's taken over his starting role. Billy Taylor said, hey, this is a kid who's been here for a long time. He just wants to win. He doesn't care if he's starting here or not. He remembers 5-23 all too well. Rodriguez. Resnick's a good outside shooter. They feed the post and they draw the foul. It's going to go against Tia, number two on him.
An excellent defensive sequence there for Lehigh. However, the ability to post up right in the middle of the lane when the ball is at the top of the key is something that most coaches will tell you is a key factor. When the ball's at the top of the key, there's no help side defense, and that's why you want to get that duck in that post. That was first established by UCLA, the old high post offense. It's the high post duck in.
Get it to Petrakis, and he hits. Raymondus Petrakis sits the three-pointer right off the inbounds. 5 points now for him.
Typical European big fella can bang inside defensively and step out, hit the jump shot.
This is Rowland. That one's knocked away. Rodriguez. Matei Kresnik now. Big guy puts it on the floor. Nice little baby hook, but it doesn't go. M. Gabroff comes out of there with the rebound for Lehigh. Olivero back in the game. Olivero hanging and hitting. Jose Olivero.
Excellent body control, using your body to try and create a foul, but also keeping those shoulders square to the backboard allows you to finish on a difficult drive.
First two for the freshman. Linus Lekavicius in the game. He's number 43. This is Rodriguez. Now the turnaround, no good. Battle for the loose ball, and the shooter gets it back as it's tracked down by Petrakis. Now Lekavicius. This is Kresnik. Offense right here for American. Petrakis on Kresnik. Rodriguez with the shot clock down to 5. Andres Rodriguez gets the high screen. He's got to get something off right here. Just chucks it up there. It hits the rim, and the rebound comes out to M. Gabroff.
Still, Lehigh had to defend for about 60 seconds there. That takes away your legs and limits your ability to shoot jump shots. And what Jeff Jones is trying to do is run his sets, dictate who gets jump shots, and if all else fails, you get the ball to Rodriguez to penetrate.
Nice feed by Olivero down low. M. Gabroff can't finish, but he draws the foul. It's going to go against Matei Kresnik.
That high post is such a deadly place to have the basketball because when teams collapse, boom, there's the big fella open on the weak side. M. Gabroff gets a chance to add to his point total.
M. Gabroff already with 6 points in the game, leading the Mountain Hawks. He misses that one. A lot of freshmen contributing for them. You see Andre Ingram come back into the game for American. Speaking of great freshmen, the Patriot League Freshman of the Year. M. Gabroff hits one of two.
A little different conditioning in the Patriot League as far as the tournament. You're not playing back-to-back-to-back nights. Matter of fact, you have a week off between the semis and the finals. When you haven't played in a week, sometimes that's difficult to be in shape for.
It's knocked away in the post by Emgerbroff. Olivero chases it down, but it's going to go to America.
I mean, you can run as many line drills as you want and as many fast break drills as you want to try and be in shape, but game competition is just a different kind of conditioning, Dave.
Talking about that with Jeff Jones yesterday, and he said, especially with his team having lost the last 2 years, they kind of wanted to get at it. Jadaeus Strong misses right there. Nurse now with the rebound. Here comes Austin Rowland for Lehigh. Rowland, little shake and bake, moves it for Edgar Broughton. Wow, Rowland can play.
Yes, not only can he play, but he's unselfish. Every time he's double-teamed, you'll see his eyes looking for his teammates, and his teammates know that. That's why Edgar Broughton cut to the basket. Beautiful feed from the Conference Player of the Year.
9 points now for Edgar Broughton. A two-point lead for the Eagles. Jason Thomas. This is Rodriguez working around the screen. Andres Rodriguez kicks it back out to no one in particular. And it's going to go to Lehigh. It's an 18-16 game. Lehigh hasn't been there for a long time. They hope some ancient history will repeat. Up by two, the Patriot League player of the action doing his thing, Doug.
Yeah, player of the year for a reason. Watch him read the help as Austin Rowland comes down the floor. The help defense comes. Emgerbroff inside. You always have to have your eyes up. You know, when you're the leading scorer for a team, you're thinking, get it on the break. I want to get a jump shot. I want to get a quickie before the defense stops to set around what I have to do. But he always has his eyes up, and that's why he is player of the year, not just because of his scoring, but also his ability to dish the rock.
This is Austin Rowland. 3 years at Delaware before coming to Lehigh. Now Jose Olivero. Olivero into the lane. The pull up there is well short. And American comes out of there with a chance to build on the 2-point lead. Rodriguez. Jadaeus Strong. Thomas coming off the screen. Can't get it to go. And the rebound to Emgerbroff. Rowland for three. Not there. Rebound to Nurse. Now Montserrat. This is Austin Rowland again trying to create something. Rowland gets down in under, maybe too deep as he throws it away. Rodriguez now has it for American. And he lays it in.
Rodriguez clearly very strong with that ball in his right hand. And if you're Lehigh, the adjustment you want to make is how do we make him dribble with his left hand without giving him a clear lane to the basket?
Rolling again. Olivero. Dishes it inside Emgerbroff. He goes off with him, and it's going to go to American.
And that was a pass that clearly Emgerbroff was not ready for. When you throw it to a big guy, especially when you jump in the lane, and the big fella's not going to see where the ball comes from, you almost have to throw it right at his head because it's just reactive. If the ball's coming at your head, you're going to get your hands up and at least knock it down. But if you throw it any lower, a lot of times big fellas don't even see it until it's already past them.
This from a guy who should know, Doug Gottlieb. Former national leader in assists at Oklahoma State. Well, anxious about the Cowboys today?
Anxious. Joe Lunardi said if they lost today, this is the bracketologist from ESPN.com, said if they lost today, they're a three seed. How can that be?
Call the lane in. They call the charge against Andre Ingram. So it's going to be number one on him.
You know, watch Kyle Neptune, the true freshman, plants his feet as Ingram leaves his feet in the lane. Oh, yes, that would be an offensive foul. You hear that? Let's go. The read is loose. Let's go. The freshman even trying to lead for Lehigh.
Kyle Neptune getting him fired up.
I would agree. I think Oklahoma State's at worst to Tucson. To finish up the bracketology discussion.
16 of the last 17 games they've won. They play Texas, who they've already beaten twice this year.
We've never finished the hot dog discussion.
No.
That's one for the ride. Yes. Kyle Neptune now. And he gets fouled on the way up by Jason Thomas. Number one on Thomas.
Well, here's the number one seeds as I see them, Dave.
You're no bracketologist.
No, I'm not. I had a minor in bracketology, not a major. Duke has to be a number one seed, as does Kentucky. Those are considered the two best leagues in the country, and those are the two best teams in those leagues. And Stanford, the best out west. Oklahoma State and St. Joe's. I mean, St. Joe's got blown out. They've had a marvelous year, and they're a terrific story. And I think they're as dangerous as anybody in the tournament. But Oklahoma State is in the Big 12, which put two teams in the Final Four last year and won the league by two games.
Kyle Neptune hitting one of two. And it's going to be fascinating to see what happens with St. Joe's. Again, ESPN, the place to be throughout the night. Selection special at 7 o'clock. And you will find out who those number one seeds are. Janae's draw. And the foul going to go against Emgebron.
This game is interesting to bracketologists because they could be in the opening round game, the game that's played in Dayton every year, the 65th and 64th best teams as far as RPI, as far as standings in the national basis. Winner of this game could be playing in Dayton.
There you take a look at the RPIs as Janae Strawn hits the first of two. You see American probably in better shape than Lehigh. Now you say, well, there are already three teams that are in the league. They're in the dance, rather. Two teams in the dance that have worse RPIs. So doesn't that mean the Lehigh would automatically not be in that opening round game? That's really not the case. Speaking with Bob Bowlesby earlier this week, and he said you have to look at the RPI as kind of a blunt instrument. This isn't a fine instrument. If there are 5 or 10 spots between two teams, that doesn't mean that the team with the better RPI necessarily is going to end up with a better seed.
By the way, that is a great game and a great atmosphere in Dayton, Ohio.
Austin Rowland.
Roland goes in to score this bucket. What's even more impressive, as you see, creates the lane. Very good balance. But Emgebron, when you watch the big fellas from Lehigh, this is a John McLeodism, and Billy Taylor played for John McLeod at Notre Dame. They like to choke the point guard. That doesn't mean Latrell Sprewell, put your hands on your coach. That means when the ball goes in the basket, the nearest big fella stands next to the point guard, not allowing him to get the ball in quick and create a fast break.
Getting fouled on the way to the hoop there was Montserrat. As we remind you, the championship week presented by 7-Up continues with two more games on ESPN today. First and one, Eastern Maryland takes on Duke in the ACC championship game. At 3 Eastern, it's a game we were talking about. Texas taking on Oklahoma State, the Phillips 66 Big 12 championship. The Big 12 championship game also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your local cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Championship week presented by 7-Up on ESPN and ESPN2. As Andre Ingram misses the first of two free throws as he was fouled by Earl Nurse. The one on Nurse. Ingram, there you see his parents, Lucius and Eva. They come to every game, have had a great time following their son. They live in Richmond, Virginia.
Made the trip to Hawaii to see their son play as well.
That's not exactly a huge sacrifice, but impressive nonetheless, distance-wise. See if they make the trip to Alaska if they go there, right? They'll know how dedicated they really are. Rowland hits Austin Rowland. That's a two for Austin Rowland.
The former Delaware Bluehead, the ability to shake and shoot. Again, when you're a leading scorer and teams are magnetized by when you dribble the basketball, sometimes scoring in the open court in the fast break is the easiest way to get a clean look at the basket.
All right, now you busted me on hot dog. They're not magnetized. It's not a magnet. They're magnified.
Come on. Magnified, not magnetized.
All right.
You're snooty Northwestern alum.
If you're going to bust me on hot dog, I'm going to bust you on magnetized. All right, keep the magnets away from our television screens right here. We don't want something to happen to those. Foul goes against Earl Nurse. That's number two on him. I mean, you asked for it. That's my only point there. Jason Thomas heads to the line. Comes from some good bloodlines. His father, Wilbur, in the American Hall of Fame. Great star for the Eagles in the 70s. Teammate of Kermit Washington on some of those great teams. They had some tremendous success in the NIT. Kermit Washington, last guy to average 20 points and 20 rebounds in a season of college basketball.
And a guy who was essentially vilified for one act on a basketball floor.
Of course, referring to the Rudy Tomjanovich incident there. Nick Monsieret comes out of there with the rebound off the miss. In case you're wondering, he is indeed the brother of Mike Monsieret of Butler.
Formerly of Notre Dame.
That's right. A lot of Notre Dame connections in this game.
Where is Richard P. Phelps?
I believe somewhere in Bristol right about now. Getting ready for bracketology. Off the miss right there. Rebound, Nick Monsieret, the aforementioned. So they get the fresh 35. They get it in the hands of Roland and see what he can do. The pull up from about 16 rolls off. Rebound and getting fouled on the way up is Dave Mickelson. Foul goes against Petrauskas. They're going to say it was a foul on the floor, so it won't be a shooting foul. It is a 3-point lead for the Eagles.
Texas in the Big 12 championship, but now let's go back to those guys, Dave and Doug.
Well, you know, it's interesting that Steve Lavin brings that up since his Final Four included Purdue and UCLA at the start of the year. Neither of those teams, at least in my mind, will be playing in the NCAA tournament.
He was campaigning for Purdue as recently as 2 weeks ago when their RPI was in the 90s. So, I mean, let's be honest here. Kyle Neptune hitting the three. The freshman comes through.
If you're going to promote a team, at least make it a good one, Lab.
Jhené is drawn now, and he draws the foul. That's going to go against Kyle Neptune.
I'd say the best thing about Steve Lavin is his ability to take and make a joke.
No doubt.
Matter of fact, came on to ESPN Radio and said UCLA will be the surprise team this year. And I said, look, UCLA, they weren't any good last year, coach. He said, yeah, that's because I was coaching them.
That foul actually went against Mickelson. So that's number two for him. Certainly looked like it was Kyle Neptune. Drawn hits the first free throw.
And Jhené Drawn is just so athletic and so aggressive inside. And when you look at the mid-major level, you see big players that, yeah, look, if he plays at Virginia just down the road, or if he plays at Georgetown, he gets lost in the shuffle because he's undersized to play inside. But at American, he can be a factor. He can be a threat because of his athletic ability, despite his lack of height.
Has a Virginia connection, actually the cousin of Brian Stith, who was a great star for Jones at Virginia before heading to the NBA. They didn't know about the relationship, at least Jeff Jones did, until he made the home visit with Jhené Drawn. It came out as he was talking to his parents. A foul there. That's going to send Kyle Neptune to the line. And Neptune just has a ton of energy, doesn't he, Doug?
Yeah, he does. And every time he's fouled, every time he makes a play, he's telling his teammates, let's go, let's go. And this is what you love. It's championship week. Lehigh playing for the right to go back to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1988. American U has never been to the NCAA tournament. You love when even a freshman has great energy.
Kyle Neptune hits the first of two free throws. Jason Thomas picking up foul number two for him there. 5 points now for Neptune. He's from Brooklyn. First team all Brooklyn last year, along with Sebastian Telfair and Pitt's Chris Tapp. That's a pretty good company. Played at a tiny, tiny private school, which really cut down on the recruiting interest, but he has turned into a great player for Billy Taylor very early on in his career.
And again, you see the big fella choking the point guard. That means just preventing them from getting the ball in quickly and fast breaking off a made shot.
Now Ingram knocked away. And it's going to stay with American. Good tight ball game here. NCAA tournament bid on the line. American and Lehigh. Lehigh hasn't been since 1988. American has never been. Ingram hitting. A two for Andre Ingram gives him eight.
And the peek over his shoulder at the student section for Lehigh.
And there you see the Ingrams. Evan Ingram and Lucius Ingram enjoying that. Now Austin Rowland trying to answer. Working the baseline is Neptune, and he gets the roll.
And all this action is created by the point guards, creating lanes, creating openings.
Now Rodriguez nearly knocked away there, gets it back. Rodriguez going to shoot it and cannot get it to go. Edgar Brown, the rebound for Lehigh. We wind down towards the final minute of the first half. It's been entertaining. Lehigh on top, 28-27. Rowland for three. Can't get it to go. And American comes the other way. Trying to retake the lead. Beautiful pass by Rodriguez inside, and they do retake the lead as Raymondis Petrakis hits.
And Petrakis caught Michael Fishman just sleeping. He was running back up the floor, but you have to keep an eye on the basketball, especially with Andres Rodriguez. He will dish the rock at any moment as soon as he sees an opening.
There is Fishman out top. Now Montserrat. Inside, Emgabrov as his defender fell down. That was Petrakis inside, and Emgabrov gets the hoop. Good alertness there.
A tremendous back and forth action in this game has gotten close, and it looks like America will take a timeout knowing they want to go into the half with the lead, something they've had the entire first half until late.
30-29 in favor of the Mountain Hawks as we take a moment to remind you later today, ESPN, the exclusive unveiling of the 2004 Women's Championship brackets at 5 Eastern. Reese Davis, Nell Forger, Stacey Dale Schubin break down the 2004 NCAA Women's Championship. Sports Center will follow that at 6 Eastern, then at 7 Eastern. Bracketology 101 in session. Chris Fowler, Nick Vitale, Digger Phelps get reaction from some of the teams involved in this year's tournament and prepare you to fill out your brackets. It is Bracketology 101, the NCAA Men's Selection Special, presented by Staples. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Trying to be the Cinderella team of this year's tournament, Lehigh went in 1985 and 1988. There you see Dick.
And Dick Vitale, who, have you seen him in the new Hooters commercials?
I have.
Hooters air commercials?
Yes, I have seen him in Hooters.
You know, his new book is called Living the Dream, right?
Yeah.
I think the Hooters commercial completes the Living the Dream.
It's an unlikely scenario, but it's worked out. Andres Rodriguez out top. It takes some time now. About an 8-second differential, so they are going to have to shoot it. Can't hold for the last shot here. Rodriguez. Ingram now. Little hanger with three on the shot clock. Can't get it to go. And coming out of there with the rebound is Neptune. He's got about 6 seconds. Took a quick glance at the clock. Kyle Neptune going to try to go one-on-one. Pulls up for the three. Can't get it to go. And that'll do it for the first half. So a very exciting back-and-forth first half. A Lehigh team that is 14-2 this year when leading at the break has a 30-29 advantage at the half right now. In the Patriot League Championship game, let's now go to the studio, Pam Ward and Steve Lavin, for our 7-Up halftime report.
Thank you, Dave. And as you mentioned, this is the 7-Up halftime report. Great game going on there between Lehigh and American. Pam Ward along with Steve Lavin. Now, American, their players have not been to the NCAA tournament, but their head coach knows all about it.
Yeah, one of the neat stories, Jeff Jones, who played at Virginia, played for Terry Holland during some of the great Virginia teams out of the ACC, and now hoping that his team can experience that thrill. He's been to the winner's circle. He's been in the NCAA tournament, knows what that's like, and he's done a nice job at American of building this program back. He had some good years at Virginia, but struggled down the stretch in his career as a head coach after he took over for Terry Holland, and it's nice to see him kind of resurrect his career here.
And he tries to get them to the NCAA tournament for the first time ever. Coming up, the ACC championship game on ESPN. Maryland taking on Duke. We will look ahead to that game as well as the Big 12 championship coming up on the 7-Up Halftime Report.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week, presented by 7-Up, is brought to you by the new 4-for-all pizza. Everyone gets the toppings they want, and it's only at Pizza Hut. We'll be right back. ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week, presented by 7-Up, is brought to you by Lexus and their passionate pursuit of perfection.
A ton of emotion on display here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. A great first half of basketball. They'll come down to the final 20 minutes for an NCAA bid. Lehigh on top by one over American at the half. Dave Revson, Doug Gottlieb with you. And both of our Star Watch players have made their presence felt in the first half.
Yeah, Andres Rodriguez from American, when he's gotten into the lane and penetrated, has five assists so far. American has had the lead. Now, when they've limited his penetration, clearly American does not have the offensive potency to keep up with Lehigh. So it really comes down to how he penetrates the basketball. And when we look at Lehigh, Austin Rowland, 7 points, two assists, and when your best player really wants to dish the rock, it's something that guys like Jason Emgebroff, who averages just under 7 points a game but has 11 already, clearly he's been the recipient of some fine passes. And those two players, as they go, so goes their team. It's very cliche to say so, but keep an eye on this game, and whomever of the two guards who are guarding each other right now plays better will probably win this game and advance to the NCAA tournament.
We'll see if that's what it comes down to. Lehigh trying to get to the tournament for the first time since 1988. American has never been there. Two straight years, they have been knocked out in this game. Both times by Holy Cross. This is Austin Rowland now. Works around the screen for Nurse. Nurse gets it back. Now Olivero, the pull up, that doesn't go. And Lehigh's going to get it back.
Now, Lehigh holds a slight rebound advantage in the first half, and that's clearly a point of emphasis for Billy Taylor's. Crash that glass if you throw up some bricks.
They are 14-1 this year when out-rebounding their opponents. Out-rebounded American 21-15 before the break in this one. Something Jeff Jones said he was really concerned about yesterday as Olivero gets the first two of the second half.
And Jose Olivero, the ability to penetrate and create. We've seen it several times this afternoon with both the right and the left hand, just a freshman.
Janaeus drawn. Now Andres Rodriguez, his first chance here in the second half. A down low on the blocks. Okpai can't hit. Gets it back, though. Okpai kicks it out. Thomas inside, Janaeus drawn. That won't go. Battle for the ball, and Olivero comes out of there with it for Lehigh.
And Emgebov very smartly plays behind, uses his size and his length to cause the miss.
Nurse misses the three ball. Ooh. Nice spin move on the blocks, and Janaeus drawn is going to go to the free throw line. Nurse gets called for the foul. As we take a look at the stats, anything else that jumps out at you besides the rebounds?
Just the rebounds. I mean, it's an evenly played game, a one-point game at the half, and that's why you're seeing those numbers being on the exact same plane. But if Lehigh continues to battle on the boards and continues to lead on the boards, they're going to get more shot attempts. And any coach tell you get more shot attempts, more free throw attempts than the opposing team. In most cases, you're going to win that game.
The foul there went on Earl Nurse. That was number three on him. So we will keep an eye on number 34 for Lehigh as Janaeus drawn hits the free throw. Guy who played 2 years ago at Hagerstown Community College. As Nurse comes out of the game. And Dane Mickelson comes in. He had played six games for the Eagles as a freshman. Returned to AU last year and has been a fixture in the lineup for them the last couple years. And Janaeus drawn hits them both.
Think about the difference from when he left and American U was a team that won single digits to now, and that they're in their second of their back-to-back championship game runs here in the Patriot League.
Now you just saw Jeff Jones, obviously a huge part of that. 10 straight losing seasons, and now they've had three straight winning seasons and three straight appearances in this championship game as Austin Rowland gets points numbers 8 and 9.
And Rowland continued self-confidence despite the fact he did not have a good first half shooting the basketball.
Drawn misses, and now going over the back and getting called for the foul is Patrick Okpai.
Watch Rowland. As we said, the matchup of the point guards is essential. And he's got Rodriguez isolated. Nice little spin move. The hop into the jump shot. And that one will count.
pressure from American, and Olivero able to break it himself. Olivero going to the hoop, and he has it rejected. A great block by Okpot. Here comes American, drawing. Let's slow things up. Jumper on the way, no good, and the rebound to Montserrat. This is Roland spinning into the lane. Olivero going to pull it back out. Lehigh, 5-23 2 years ago. A remarkable turnaround under Billy Taylor. The steal by Rodriguez. Taking it himself, and he gets hammered by Montserrat.
Just a freshman, but having an outstanding freshman season. But when you see the big fella back there, Okupai, I think that one was blocked by his underarm.
I think so. It was fairly emphatic.
Yes.
That's the first on Nick Montserrat. So Rodriguez to the stripe. Very good students. Should not come as a surprise in this league. Hits the free throw there. Took the LSAT February 7th at Bucknell. He finished at 12:30. He played the game at 3:15.
And Jeff Jones was not very happy that he took the LSAT on a Saturday. That's the day of the game.
6 points, 4 assists, 4 steals in that ballgame, so well below his average. This is a very unique league, though. 8 very prestigious schools, American, Army, Bucknell, Colgate, Holy Cross, Lafayette, Lehigh, and Navy, have led the nation in graduation rate 5 straight years.
You know, it's not the graduation rate where they're taking basket weaving. These are big-time schools and big-time academic institutions.
Another huge block. Here comes American on the break, and Thomas going to finish it off.
And the athleticism of the American big fellas starting the fast break and then finishing the baskets at the other end.
So it's 35-34 in favor of the Eagles. Can't hit, and the rebound to Okpai, who's really made his presence felt here in the second half.
Look at the movement, the pep in the step of American, whereas Lehigh seems to be standing around on offense.
Thomas, shot clock winding down to 15. Got a foul away from the ball. That's going to go against Montserrat. That'll be number 2 on him. Lehigh having some troubles inside as American gets the block from Okpai. They get the basket in transition. It's the Eagles on top by 1. It's a 35-34 game, American on top. Don't forget ESPN, the exclusive unveiling of the 2004 Women's Championship brackets at 5 Eastern today as Reese Davis, Nell Fortner, and Stacey Dale Schumann break down the 2004 NCAA Women's Championship. Then it's SportsCenter at 6 Eastern. Then it's 7 Eastern. Bracketology 101 in session. Chris Fowler, Dick Vitale, Digger Phelps getting reaction from some of the teams involved in the tournament, preparing you to fill out your brackets on Bracketology 101, the NCAA Men's Selection Special presented by Staples. As we look at Mike Montserrat, whose team at Butler made a great run last year into the Sweet 16. They will not be in this year. And he has come to watch his brother Nick play here for Lehigh.
Yeah, he actually attended Notre Dame with his brother when when Mike took an official visit, and Billy Taylor was an assistant coach at Notre Dame.
Billy Taylor actually gave them the tour around campus. The Montserrat family was showing Mike around, and she said Nick was tagging along. So Billy Taylor said when he saw his name on the roster when he took over in Lehigh, he said, "This time I'm going to know one guy."
Billy Taylor was a player at Notre Dame when I visited and then committed to the Irish.
It really is all going back to Notre Dame. There's
no Digger Phelps, Bracketology 101.
Off the miss, the rebound goes to Montserrat.
Unfortunately, I think the Irish will be playing in the other tournament, the NIT.
It is not going to be an NCAA bid for Notre Dame. That is almost assured. But for a while, there's if Mike Gray's team might get in. Need to go a little bit deeper in the Big East tourney as Emgebrov gets fouled.
You know, if we really want to bring it all back to Notre Dame, we can look at Austin Rowland, the player of the year in this conference, who transferred into Lehigh for his senior season. And he began his career for Mike Bray at Delaware and then transferred. How about this? He's a senior, only playing 1 year at Lehigh, and yet his teammates voted him co-cap.
And they put him on the cover of the media guide. The foul was on Patrick Okpai.
He's also got two losses in championship games at Delaware. And American U, they know about losing in championship games, but he actually went into the locker room and after their last victory and said, look, guys, I know what it's like to lose championship games. It's not any fun. We got to play this entire week of practice with all of our hearts.
13 now for M. Gabroff. One of the interesting things that Billy Taylor said when talking about the turnaround, he gave a lot of credit to last year's turnaround to Austin Rowland. Even though he didn't play, he said he was by far their best practice player and really made all of these guys better. As the jumper is left well short by Andre Ingram. And now Lehigh coming the other way, Austin Rowland. M. Gabroff out top.
A mismatch inside of epic proportions as Rodriguez is stuck on a big fella.
Trying to get it to Mickelson. They were unable to do so, and then Neptune falls down and travels.
See, sometimes you try so hard to find that mismatch because Rodriguez was caught on Mickelson and has a size advantage of about a foot. But suddenly you play too quickly, and that's what took place with the freshman Neptune.
36-35. It's been a great back-and-forth game here. Patriot League Championship. Birth of the NCAA tourney on the line. Both these teams hoping to be the latest Cinderella. Andre Ingram falls down there, kept his dribble, though. Now Andres Rodriguez working around the screen. Rodriguez gets into the lane, leaves it short off the glass. Rebound, Okpai, though, and he puts it back up and in.
And again, Rodriguez penetrating the basket. At the basketball with his right hand, very strong with the right hand, and when he gets in that lane, the entire American team seems to be so much more cognizant of looking for the basketball either when he shoots it or when he passes it.
Rod Tia gonna try the three. That's not there, and the foul is gonna go against Dane Mickelson, and that's gonna be number three on him.
And if you could try and pick apart one reason Lehigh has struggled offensively, it's been guys somehow finding ways to come out of their role in the second half. Ratia is more of a mid-range jump shooter, very athletic, very active at the defensive end. He jumps up and shoots a three the very first time he touches the ball in a possession. Same thing happened with Jose Olivero, who is sitting on the bench now. He jumps up and shoots a three with a hand in his face, and Billy Taylor pulled him out of the game. So they need to take shots in rhythm and within the context of their offense.
Linus Lekavicius back in the game for Lehigh, wears number 43. That's Matej Kresnik, 41, also back in there. Kresnik very quiet in this game. Jeff Jones says he thinks he's his best player, and you see part of the reason why right there.
Good call, Dave. Very good call. I mean, perfect timing.
Ooh, I can.
Who's going to score at Lehigh? Who is Lehigh's best player? It would be Austin Rowland.
I don't have that information.
Okay. This is a nice drop step. A little balanced dribble, creates rhythm, goes up with the jumper.
Kyle Neptune. And a very good first half for himself. Tia gets it on the baseline. Mickelson draws the foul. And that's going to go against Kresnik.
Now Tia playing much more to his strengths as he penetrates, creates the help, and feeds the big fella Mickelson.
Second foul going against Kresnik. Third on the team. So Dane Mickelson goes to the line. Another guy who is from the state of Washington. And one of three players on this Lehigh team from that state, along with Kevin Tempest and Jason M. Gabroff. And the connection once again there is Matt Logie, Mountain Hawks all-time leader in three-pointers made. Director of basketball operations after graduating last year. He is a native of Mercer Island, Washington, and they've done some great recruiting out there getting players from the state of Washington. Rodriguez spinning, kicking it back out. Kresnik's a guy who can shoot from three. This is Rodriguez. Lekavicius. He'll pull up on the baseline that doesn't go, and Neptune comes out of there with the rebound for Lehigh. Arati gonna bring it back out top. Ready, go.
39-36 American. They have never been to the NCAA tournament. They did make it to a couple Division II Final Fours. Tia missing the three. Rebound Andres Rodriguez.
And again, an excellent defensive sequence by America.
Kresnik gets called for the offensive foul. So very quickly, Matei Kresnik picking up fouls number two and three. We're going to take a break. It is a very tight one here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. American on top by three. All right, thanks, Pam. Pam, an alum of the University of Maryland. Terps looking good early, and it's been Okpie looking good in the second half here.
Yeah, Patrick Okpie, two blocks in the second half, has started two fast breaks, and then the ability to finish. He also has three boards in the second half, and there's his only 2 points. But sometimes it's a little thing where he's blocking a shot, getting an extra rebound that gets you an extra offensive possession. Those are the little things it takes to get past the championship game and into the NCAA tournament.
See Okpie taking a seat there. Jeff Jones just raves about his athleticism. He may very well be the best athlete on their team.
He's coached some pretty fine athletes at Virginia as well, so I think he knows when a guy is highly athletic.
This is Tia. They're going to try the alley-oop, and Andres Rodriguez sniffed that one out. Rodriguez throwing ahead to Lekavicius, and that is intercepted by Austin Rowland. So a couple of turnovers. Rowland on the break now, and it's Neptune. Now Nurse. Neptune going to try the three, and the freshman hits.
He has provided great energy off the bench for Lehigh today, and just incredible confidence, constantly trying to give his teammates that big push that a freshman and a bench player needs.
Tie ball game, 11 points for Neptune, nearly doubling his season average. Kresnik still out there with three fouls. Lekavicius, this is Kresnik. Now inside to the big guy, and he gets fouled. Going to go against Earl Nurse, and that's going to be number four on him.
Watch the inside-out action. It's one thing to throw the ball in the post, but you also have to relocate, get your feet set, and up and shoot. And that is such a much better shot percentage-wise than simply jumping up, whether it's off the dribble or off the pass and shooting.
So Matej Kresnik goes to the line to shoot two. Really a tragic story. He's a native of Slovenia. His mother came to visit him for a week from Slovenia 2 years ago. She suffered a heart attack on her way back to her hotel room. She had gone out to buy some food. She was going to cook him a native Slovenian meal. Suffered a heart attack, was hit by a car, and was killed on her visit. So really just a terrible story. But Matej Kresnik has persevered. Hits both of the free throws. 41-39, American on top. Rowland.
Jeez, what a play. Now Rowland's ability to step up and make a play here as Lehigh had struggled to score the basketball in the second half.
11 points for the Patriot League Player of the Year.
I think it just comes down to whom of these 2 point guards plays better and makes bigger plays, makes bigger shots down the stretch.
Tie ball game. It's going to come down to the final 10-19 for an NCAA tournament bid. Crowd starting to come to life a little bit here in Bethlehem. Rodriguez going to try the three, trying to do his part. Andre Ingram does a good job getting the board. Rodriguez now penetrating and dishing and getting called for the offensive foul.
And guess who's there to take the charge? That's his third charge today for Kyle Neptune, the true freshman, planting his feet. And that is a turnover.
Championship week presented by 7-Up, the Patriot League Championship. American against Lehigh here at the Stable Arena in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Dave Revson, Doug Gottlieb with you. It all comes down to this in this league. It's a one-bid league. Lehigh and American playing for a bid in the NCAA tournament. American has never been to the tournament. Lehigh hasn't been since 1988. Great interior feed as Neptune gets it inside to Mickelson, and he gets his first two.
It's been the Kyle Neptune show defensively, taking charge, hitting threes at the offensive end, and then how about sharing with a friend?
They are fired up here, just 9:33 away from their first bid in 16 years. Lehigh up two.
Kentucky, perhaps playing for a number one seed. We'll keep you updated on the Duhon situation. Here's 6 ties, 12 lead changes. It's a 2-point lead for Lehigh, and Cal Neptune, a big part of the reason
why. Yeah, the true freshman from Brooklyn, New York, hitting the three with great balance. And then you also have to do it at the defensive end. He's taken 3 offensive charges today as he takes one on Andres Rodriguez and then also sharing with a friend.
So Kyle Neptune, the freshman, 11 points for him. His career high is 17. Guy who averages just under 6 per game, making a big difference as Lehigh tries to get to the dance. Ingram can't get it to go. And the rebound yanked out of there by Mickelson. Rolling. The pull up just inside the arc is well short. Mickelson tries to save it, but it's going to go to the Eagles. Championship week presented by 7-Up concludes today. 3 Eastern on ESPN as Texas meets Oklahoma State for the Phillips 66 Big 12 Championship. That game is also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Championship week presented by 7-Up on ESPN and ESPN2. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Janaeus Drawn through the lane, gets it to go.
American just finding ways to manufacture enough points. They're much better in transition, especially when Rodriguez has the ball, usually created by a rebound or a block shot.
43-43 as we wind down in the final 8.5 minutes of this game. Ratia.
And a little bit earlier, it was critical of him jumping up and shooting a 3-point shot. However, when he goes to the basket, we've seen him create for teammates, and he's so much better scoring when he's inside that 15-foot range.
4 points now for Tia. Lehigh back out on top by 2. Now in the corner, jumper on the way, not there. By Thomas. Ingram battles for the board. Thomas gets it back, gets it inside. It is blocked by Mickelson. Lehigh up by 2. They haven't been in 16 years, hoping some ancient history will repeat.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up and your local 7-Up bottler. Make 7-Up yours.
Lehigh up by 2, trying to get back to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1988 when Fran McCaffrey, now the coach at UNC Greensboro, was their head coach, and Fran McCaffrey in attendance here today.
Fran McCaffrey actually recruited me to Notre Dame, as well as he recruited Billy Taylor, the head coach of Lehigh, to Notre Dame. He was the head coach at Lehigh, felt like there was a ceiling to what kind of bigger head coaching jobs he'd get, so he went on the staff of one Richard P. Digger Phelps at Notre Dame, hoping to land a bigger job, and ended up landing at UNC Greensboro after being on John McCloud's staff for a number of years.
Also on John McCloud's staff was Billy Taylor, who then followed Fran McCaffrey to UNC Greensboro. And Fran McCaffrey really encouraged him to apply for this job. He's very fond feelings for Lehigh and felt like this would be a good place for Billy Taylor. Now off the miss, Lehigh comes out of there with it in the person of Austin Rowland.
And I think Fran McCaffrey's career really epitomizes how difficult it is at a mid-major level to have continued success. He got the NCAA tournament at UNC Greensboro and was offered several higher end jobs, held on for a bigger one, and stayed at UNC Greensboro, and they've had a couple of down years since. So it's that difficult. And people say, well, why do you leave after you have one good year? Because it's so hard to duplicate that success year after year after year, because every coach is fighting for that dream, the NCAA tournament.
Just the 10th turnover there for Lehigh, 8-4 American. It's been a fairly clean game so far. Fran McCaffrey very, very happy for Billy Taylor. Great pass inside. Petrakis had a little problem with it, though. So they reset things. Rodriguez. The jumper out of the corner is left well short by Thomas. This is rolling against the screen for Mickelson. Aratia. Got a hoop penetrating earlier, and here he draws the foul.
He's just so much more effective going to the basket. Aratia, explosive athletically, puts his head down, gets into that lane. And he had the mindset he was going up from the time he drove. And a lot of times, officials will reward offensive players who are more aggressive.
Second foul on Andres Rodriguez as Aratia misses the first of his two free throws. Guy who shoots about 78% on the year.
American's been much more effective when they're in the open floor, but at the half court level, they haven't been efficient offensively. Interesting to see what Jeff Jones does as far as making adjustments, trying to get Andres Rodriguez into the lane, because they're doing a tremendous job going underneath the on-ball screens and really just closing up the gaps, because when he creates penetration, suddenly American becomes a much better offensive unit.
Going straight to the hoop is Jadaeus Drawn. He can't get it to go. Rebound to Kresnik, and he is fouled by Kyle Neptune.
And there's one way. You get the ball to Jadaeus Drawn. He is constantly a mismatch. He's listed at 6'5", probably more along the 6'3.5", 6'4" guidelines. And he gets the ball, spins to the basket with quickness, just gets the ball up. And what happens is when he gets to the basket, you have to collapse and try and block his shot. Well, that's where it allows for other big players to come in and get a rebound.
Mate Kresnik hitting the first free throw. Did not play basketball until he was 17. Was actually the Slovenian junior national tennis champion. Was roommates in his school with Bojan Nakbar, now the Rockets, who turned him on to hoops.
Yeah, he's a tremendous player for the Rockets. That can really shoot.
Kresnik hits them both. Salivero checks back in for Lehigh. ...46-45 ball game as they play for the tournament bid here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. A Lehigh team that was 5-23 2 years ago, trying to get into the tournament for the first time since 1988. American has never been. They've had a great turnaround as well under Jeff Jones. Had 10 straight losing seasons, now 3 straight winning seasons. Olivero misses. Mickelson inside, gets it to go, and draws the foul.
And again, a missed shot, but you can't keep your eyes on the basketball. You have to box out your man. And Mickelson, active, aggressive, had a shot that didn't have a normal bounce to it, and he goes up strong. And not sure I saw much of a foul there. You see what?
I tend to agree with you. Opie is the guy they gave it to, though. That's number 3 on him. Mickelson goes to the stripe. This Lehigh team shoots free throws very well. Could be critical down the stretch. Best free throw shooting team in this league at nearly 72%. And Mickelson hits that one to convert on the 3-point play.
And again, it's Billy Taylor's philosophy, preparation. Preparation comes down to scouting opponents and being able to make those free throws when you feel like you're going to have a lead.
Jason Thomas throws it away. Jeff Jones' team has come agonizingly close the last 2 years, falling to Holy Cross in the finals both times. He's trying to get American in. He said, this year, our goal is not to get to this game. Our goal was to get past this game. We've been thinking about this game for a year.
Kind of reminds me of Eastern Washington's head coach, Ray Giacoletti. They just got into the tournament for the first time after this was their 4th straight year this year in the Big Sky Conference Tournament Championship.
49-45, Lehigh. Again, Tia penetrating. Gets it out to Olivero. Now Roland. Roland gets to the hoop, kicks it back out. Olivero going to try the three, and he's got it! Jose Olivero! The lead is up to 7. Kresnik, good 3-point shooter. Can't get it to go. Rebound, Aratia.
Lehigh is about one basket and one stop away from blowing this thing open, especially as well as they shoot the ball from the free throw line.
Just one field goal in the last 6 minutes for American. They have gone stone cold at the wrong time.
Look at the difference in offensive possessions.
Tia, nice feed. Mickelson couldn't handle it, though. Kresnik comes out of there with it for American. Rodriguez. And Jeff Jones wants to talk things over.
This easily could have been a four-point play for Jose Olivero. The penetration by Roland, the player of the year in this conference, not afraid to kick it out to the freshman. And, oh, yeah, he was, I think he was touched, and it could have been a foul, but he definitely fell, gave a little whirl-be-free kick out the legs, try and draw an even bigger foul.
Olivero, his father is a Green Beret, a colonel in the U.S. Special Forces. Hits a big three-pointer right there. It's a 52-45 lead for Lehigh, as we remind you that ESPN has the exclusive unveiling of the 2004 Women's Championship brackets at 5 Eastern. Reese Davis, Nell Fortner, Stacey Dale Schumann breaking down the 2004 Women's Championship. Sports Center after that at 6 Eastern, then at 7. Bracketology in session. Chris Fowler, Dick Vitale, Digger Phelps getting reaction from some of the teams involved in this year's tourney. But get you ready to fill out your brackets as well. Bracketology 101, the NCAA Men's Selection Special presented by Staples. For more information, log on to ESPN.com, and one of these two teams will be in the bracket. And right now, it's Lehigh by 7. On the pull-up by Ingram, who gets the roll.
Now, beautiful set out of a timeout, trying to get a mid-range shot. Jeff Jones, never nervous. He's been in these situations before as head coach at Virginia. Been to the NCAA tournament, trying to let American experience that for the first time in the university's history.
The guy who took Virginia to the Elite Eight, one step away from making it to the Final Four. So he certainly knows all about tournament pressure. In this league, though, it all comes down to this day. They focus on all year. 52-47 Lehigh. Milking the clock. It's down to 4. M. Gabroff on the baseline. Can't get it to go. And Thomas gets the rebound. Rodriguez. This is drawn. Rodriguez going to try the three. Got it. Big shot, Andres Rodriguez.
Yeah, and he hasn't hit one all day. But the difference, Dave, the inside out. You double down off a guy. When the ball comes out from underneath the basket, it's so much of an easier rhythm jump shot, despite the fact he's about a 29% three-point shooter in the year.
Now trying to answer is Roland, and he does. The big guy stepping up as Austin Roland hits the three. The stars making their presence felt. This is Rodriguez. Doesn't get the call inside, and Roland comes out of there with the rebound.
How about Roland stepping up and tit for tat, making the return answer of that three-point jump shot by Rodriguez.
So the lead back up to 5 at 55-50. And Lehigh going to take a timeout.
Austin Roland. Yeah, he's conference player of the year for a reason. This is why the team knows who their best player is. They elected him co-captain, despite he only plays here for one season. And, get Andres Rodriguez some new ankle braces, because he just got shook out of them shoes.
Well, Austin Roland's been great against American this year. He's averaged 24.5 points per game against them. 14 in this ballgame. His team on top by 5. Championship week presented by 7-Up. Concluding today, Selection Sunday, 3 Eastern on ESPN. It is Texas against Oklahoma State. Phillips 66 Big 12 Championship. Also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Championship week presented by 7-Up on ESPN and ESPN2. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. A number one seed perhaps on the line there for Oklahoma State. Here you see the timeout situation. Both teams have 20. And on the next foul by Lehigh, we'll have both teams in the bonus.
And Lehigh flat out loses it. Ratia had it go off his hands, off his knee, and it's going to go to American.
You know, Ratia nearly lost the ball during the previous timeout called by Billy Taylor. Fortunately, he got it just in time, but now a costly turnover for Lehigh.
Billy Taylor in just his third season as a head coach, 2:21 away from the big dance. His team up five. Okay, thanks a lot, Pam. So that is encouraging news for Duke fans here. It's 55-50 in favor of Lehigh. As we wind down the final 2 minutes, in and out for Kresnik, and Nurse gets the rebound. And we have an injured player now down for American. They're going to continue play. It is Jason Thomas who is down for American. And now they do give them the timeout as Jason Thomas is in some serious pain.
And the rule is when the possession changes, Lehigh can go down and score. But if the defense is allowed to set up and the momentum is kind of stale, all of a sudden now the referee can stop the game and make an adjustment. Keep an eye on the right side of your screen as it's a teammate that hits him across the face. And it looked like it was Jernaeus Drawn who accidentally hit his teammate. I'm not sure if that is sweat, but it may be some of the red stuff. Is that a little blood or is that sweat?
It's hard to tell, Doug, from our perspective. I'm sorry. The officials are making the right call. And speaking of the officials, we want to give our best to Joe DiMeo there. He was supposed to officiate this game. He was involved in a car accident on Thursday. He is a very well-respected official in this league, and we certainly wish him the best for a speedy recovery.
I would say that looks like sweat because otherwise they'd have to spray down the floor for his blood.
All right. That's good analysis on your part.
I'm not a doctor, but I do play one on TV at times. Our cameraman says there's definitely blood on the floor.
Well, that's why you're not a doctor.
Okay.
So Austin Rowland handling out top and mishandling out top. He has his pocket pick. Andres Rodriguez fouled by Rowland. Will they call it intentional? No. They're not going to call the flagrant foul there.
You know, Austin Rowland has been loose with the ball all day, and all it takes is a little flick of the basketball. Sometimes a little too much crissing and crossing over. An excellent play by Andres Rodriguez.
Rodriguez will be shooting two.
Rodriguez will shoot two. 9 points in the game. Has fourth nationally in assists.
Tex Winter, the longtime assistant with the Bulls and now with the Los Angeles Lakers, has a rule. He said it's a moment of truth. When the defender is 3 feet or more in front of you, you can fool around with the basketball. But when he closes that gap, you never cross over in front of you. It's just too easy to get a hand on the basketball.
Well, Rodriguez did it there. The eighth steal for the Eagles in the ballgame. He has a chance to cut this to a one-possession game. It's going to go down to the wire here in the Patriot League. Misses the free throw, and the rebound goes to M. Gabron.
But a tremendous competitor is Rodriguez. He hits the big three, then gets the big steal, and he's been defending Rowland all night, trying to single-handedly take American to the NCAA tournament for the first time.
Now Rowland runs into the double team. That leaves M. Gabron open, but Kresnik does a good job recovering. Ratia still in the ballgame for Lehigh. Tia. Penetrating, hanging and hit a couple big shots in this game for Ratia.
He is a trick or treat guy. At times he turns it over, makes you shake your head and say, why is he in the game? Because he can create off the dribble in the middle of the lane.
Now Ingram. This is Kresnik, now Rodriguez. They're going to give him some space. The very long three, and he trades it.
The essence of a competitor, Dave. The essence of a competitor. 1 for 6 from three-point range, and yet he has the fortitude to jump up and take and make a big one. Watch the range. They've continually gone under the screen and challenged him. And look, now he's going to have to shoot over the defender's long arm, but also his own man setting the screen.
Andres Rodriguez flat out was not a scorer for them last year. They had a couple great backcourt players who did the bulk of their scoring. He has more than doubled his scoring output from last season, averaging a little bit more than 10 per game. He has 13 in this one. 57-54, and
Doug, if you could put your finger on one thing it's going to come down to here in the final minute, what would it be?
Well, I think if you're Lehigh, you have to get a good shot in this possession. You can't stop playing, stop scoring offensively, because American is going to clearly push the basketball and try and get a quick bucket. Lehigh cannot turn it over and must get a shot in this possession.
Jeff Jones, 2 years in a row, his team has been denied a chance in this game, losing in the Patriot League Championship game. Wants more than anything to get his team in for the first time in school history. They have some ground to make up, though, down by three. Lehigh able to break the pressure. And now they call a timeout. So Jose Olivero able to get it into the front court. Now Billy Taylor going to draw something up. Clearly you want it in the hands of Austin Rowland here, Doug, but what kind of play would you design here if you were Billy Taylor?
I think you need to get the ball inbounds first. Forget about who you get it to. You have to get it inbounds, because I don't think American wants to foul. I'd be surprised, because, look, if they get a defensive stop within the 35-second shot clock, 30 seconds remaining, they get a stop. They have 25 seconds left to decide, do we want a two or do we want a three? So most importantly, you have to design something to get the ball inbounds first, then get it to Austin Rowland second.
Austin Rowland, 14 points in this game, the Patriot League Player of the Year. Billy Taylor, just 30 years old, trying to get his team in. Coming up next, it's the Pacific Life Open, presented by the City of Indian Wells. Americans Jan Michael Gamble and Andy Roddick face off in second round action. That is coming up live from Indian Wells, California, as soon as we are done here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. It has been a great back and forth game between Lehigh and American. It's going to come down to the final 55 seconds, 57-54 in favor of the Mountain Hawks.
Well, there's the ball inbounds to your best ball handler. Now you have to make sure you get a shot as the shot clock expires. That's how long you want to hold.
Obviously, he is in no hurry, as you said here, Doug. And letting it wind down at about 13 seconds right now. You see the shot clock in the lower left. It's down to 10. Rowland going to try a three. Left it well short. And now Rodriguez in American. Do you call timeout here?
I go for a quick two. A quick two, because you don't need a three-point pass.
Rodriguez going to do just that. And he hits and draws the foul. How about that?
This is why you don't call a timeout in this situation, Dave, because if you call a timeout, all of a sudden you have your defensive assignments. I got him, you got him. Watch. You have a mismatch at the point guard. The big fella turns and looks the other way. Nick Monterey was kind of trying to communicate with his teammates. This is not my man. And it was just too late. Rodriguez gets a step. What a competitor. Andres Rodriguez.
Jose Olivero commits the foul. A huge free throw now for Andres Rodriguez. 62% on the season. 3 of 4 today. Make it 4 of 5. And he has come up huge. 16 points, too shy of his career high. And we are even at 57. Mountain Hawks having some trouble getting it in. Now do they call a timeout?
I wouldn't. I'd go and try the exact same philosophy. Score the basketball without allowing the defense to set up. And it's the second shot that kills you. It's never the first. Watch for the offensive rebound.
Olivero nearly loses it. We're down to 6 seconds. The hanger. He hit it. The freshman, Jose Olivero, puts Lehigh up by two.
How about the true freshman, Jose Olivero, a member of the Patriot League All-Freshman team. He scored better than 1,300 on his SAT. What's another word for big jumper? Oh, not exactly the cleanest ball handling, but you know what? It doesn't matter. In 3.9 seconds, Lehigh could be going to the dance for the first time since 1988.
Jose Olivero, he's lived in Panama, Costa Rica, Uruguay, Tampa, Fairfax, Virginia growing up. Never lived anywhere longer than 3 years, so he stays for 4 years at Lehigh. This will be the longest he's ever been anywhere. He is a military kid. You see no timeouts left now for American here, Doug. So that could be critical down the stretch.
Yeah, 3.9 seconds, though, is plenty of time to go the length of the floor. How about the turnaround Billy Taylor has engineered here as head coach at Lehigh?
Absolutely incredible story. 5-23 the season before he got here. They're 35-22 his first two seasons. Those 35 wins, three more than they had in the four seasons combined before he arrived.
Part of the last recruiting class of Digger Phelps at Notre Dame. And they joke before the game, if Lehigh wins, Digger will remember recruiting him. If not, he's a Fran McCaffrey recruit. He never saw the guy play.
59-57 Lehigh, American. Two straight years they've been denied in the championship game. They need to go the length of the court here in 4 seconds. They get it to Kresnick. The big guy nearly walked. He heaves it up. It doesn't go, and it's over. For the first time since 1988, Lehigh is dancing. They are the Patriot League champions.
Shot, they have to do it with confidence. A pretty good look, despite the fact that it's about 35 feet. But that's a lot to ask of your big fella.
So Billy Taylor and the Lehigh Mountain Hawks are headed to the dance. The 30-year-old coach in just his third season gets him in. Lehigh wins it 59-57. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. For Doug Gottlieb and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Dave Revson. Now let's join Pam Ward in our ESPN2 studios.
Thank you very much, Dave.